Some viewers may find this disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
It's going down, basement, Friday the 13th, guess who's playing Jason? Tuck yourself in, you better hold on to your teddy. It's Nightmare on Elm Street, and guess who's playing Freddy?
What's he too? Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching me, and today I'm doing a new type of video today. So in today's video, I have a new segment, which is called Movie versus Movie. Basically, what it means is I pick two different movies. Well, that's four. I picked two different movies that's kind of different, but same at the same time. And I just show the similarities and differences and what the movie is about and why you should see it. Nah, these are both thriller, horror, slasher type of movies. Basically, they're scary movies that you should watch. Okay. Well, I just finished Stories to Tell in the Dark about 2 or 3 days ago, and I love that, and I think you should watch it. Final Destination. Okay, so if you never heard of Final Destination, it's a slasher type thriller-ish kind of movie because it's like a killer, then he slices people, so a slasher. Passing the slasher, and it's 1 hour 38 minutes. So yeah, basically what Google said, this basically is about Alice Browning is embarking on a trip to Paris. Alice experiences a premonition. He sees the plane explode moments after leaving the ground. Alice insists everyone get off the plane, and 7 people, including Alice, are forced to disembark. All watch as the plane actually explodes in the fireball. He and the other survivors are briefly cheated death, but will not be able to evade their fate for very long. One by one, these fugitives from fate fall victim to the little homie Death, aka the Grim Reaper. Basically, this boy, he has visions. He see visions. He know what things are gonna happen. You know that's Raven. Some call it magic, the things I see. Basically, it's like that. After he sees, he trying to cheat Death and make sure he doesn't go, make sure they don't die. So basically, that was telling you the first part of the movie. Basically, all his friends that supposed to die in that plane is going to die, but they die one by one. All they're doing is cheating Death. Really, to be honest. Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark. I was like, this is like a modern day Final Destination, okay? Cause it's scary, but it's scary now. It's scary, but this is PG-13, meaning teenagers can watch it. Cause I think the other ones rated R, cause I think they cuss. I think they do sex scenes or whatever, so that's why it's for adults. But this one is PG-13. People can watch it. Basically, what Google said, okay, it is about the shadows of the Bellows family has loomed large in the small town of Mill Valley for generations. It's in a mansion that young Sarah Bellows turns her tortured life and horrible secrets into a series of scary stories. These terrifying tales soon have a way becoming all too real for a group of unexpected teens who stumble upon Sarah's spooky house. Basically, so this is family back in time. Okay, this movie is based in the 1960s. No, it's 1960 something. 1970. And basically, back in the day, this family was torturing and mean, really mean to their daughter Sarah, and started making diaries, and started making stories with her blood. And then she died. And fast forward, these kids stumbled into a haunted house. They went inside, they found the book, and it started going downhill after that. So I put those together because they're a group of friends, both of them group of friends in each movie, and they find something, whether it's whatever, they find something, they're not supposed to find it. and all their friends die one by one because they did something they're not supposed to. So that's what I think when it's like modern day Final Destination, okay? Because they die one by one. But Scary Stories to Stare in the Dark, that goes into foreshadowing because, I mean, flashbacks. Not really flashbacks though, because it's like, it's weird at the end of the movie, spoiler alert, the worlds collide kind of. They kind of collide, which is weird, and I love that part. And Final Destination, that goes into foreshadowing, you know? Because he sees a premonition, a vision of him dying, and he tries to cheat death. It's going to be hard because if you try to cheat death, he will find million ways to get you eventually. Okay, so be careful. Both of these. But who, I don't know who better though. I would probably have to say you know, both are born at first, you know. I mean, I'm like almost every movie is born like the first few times. Not first few times, but like the few first chapters, then when they actually get into the movie, the real story happens, not like the backstory of like that's born. Like when it actually starts happening, I thought, oh, this movie is good. This movie is good. So yeah. But I would have to say that like, they both on the same spectrum. But I would have to say like Stories to Tell in the Dark is probably better. No, I know. I think the new one is better. That's hard. I can't say which one better. That's why I'm telling you these things about these movies so you can watch it for the spooky season. Okay? Watch it for spooky season. Okay? Because I don't know. They're like on the same spectrum for me. So, I think this one good and I think this one good too. Both of these movies are bomb.com and I will watch again. So, I really don't know which one is better, to be honest. But that's it for this video. I'm gonna try to do something a little different, you know. I might do like some more movies or whatever. So yeah. So I don't see nobody else doing this, so I'm gonna be the first one. So, cause I love being original, you know, be original. Okay, so I think you should go watch those. Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark and Final Destination. I'm pretty sure whoever watching this is probably already saw Final Destination because that was like 19 years ago when it came out. So that's the end with this video. Hope you like this video. Thanks for watching. Please watch those videos. I mean, those movies. I'm not sponsored by those movies. I'm just wanting to do this because it's different for my channel. You know, I usually do rash reactions. Now I'm doing like a new segment or episode or whatever it is called. So yeah, so please subscribe because new videos are coming. I'm gonna start posting every week now. So please subscribe, like, share, and comment. And follow my social media, gonna be down below because I'm on screen because I don't feel like doing that. That's some editing. I think that's it. So see y'all my next video. Might be a movie versus movie too. So see y'all my next video. I wasn't even recording. Oh my god. Now you know who the heck I am? I'm just David, and my real name is David Myers, and I'm 19, and I'm from Maryland.
From South Carolina.
I said it wrong. Okay.
From the trenches.
Heck, I am. I'm just David. Yep. Movie versus movie. Okay? So, and and I'll be going on Hey, so welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you don't know who the heck I am, Kayla.
I meant David. You want to be me so bad, huh?
I want attention on, so you don't want to talk to him no more.
No, you do that to my boo.
I will if you don't shut up. I will, and I did it before the other people. You look like lovely peaches.
Don't you ever compare me to your sister. Your twin.
It's in the brain. It's in the brain.
Burning it. I got
SCD. Recently, I just watched Stories to Tell in the Dark.
Yes, I did. Go,
so yeah, I just watched Scary Stories to Tell.
I did too. I thought I was supposed to be in a video.
How you acting? You not finna be in a video.
Kayla.